Hey everybody, I'm just going to do a quick tutorial here on how to recover data in dedicated, specifically US PubSec for Gitaly, specifically Gitaly classic block storage or EBS volumes. So the scenario we're talking about here is if you were to need to recover data to a Gitaly node from a snapshot, either, well, specifically from or to the current region. It's important to note that we currently can only deploy FedRAMP to one region, the US West AWS GovCloud. So that's what we're going to be talking about here. Let's go over to the documentation. So if you search for, or if you search for connecting to AWS resources, this is a runbook that is in the GitLab dedicated issue tracker repository. And it's, as you can see, it's under the runbooks. This is the first step. You're going to need to connect to an AMP cluster and then start up a pod in that AMP cluster. So let's go ahead and do that. The first thing you'll want to do is change directory to the AMP repository. So if you don't have it, you'll have to grab it. The documentation here will give you some ideas of how to do that, but I'm just going to jump in. So we'll go to my AMP directory, and you can see we've automatically loaded some tools here. We are going to have to do some additional signing in. So now I'm signed into the 1Password client. This little example is actually what we need for US public sector operations or US PubSec ops. Different AMP clusters will use, different strings there, and those strings equate to something in the AMP slash environments directory. But we already know the one we want, so let's go ahead and run that. Now it's going to ask me to log in twice. Twice is correct, strangely. So that's your username at gitlab-uspublicsector.local. Then we'll grab my password here. All right, so now that's set. Let's go back to the documentation real fast. So what we've done now is we've done this part. Now the next thing we need to do is set up the Kubernetes context. Once this is done, we would be able to, I didn't show you before, but now we can do something like kubectl git spaces. And it'll, sure enough, I've got an active Kubernetes context, so that's working. Let's go back to the documentation. And so this is the next step here is that we're going to want to set the tenant model environment variable. This is going to get passed along with us to a pod that we're going to start here in a second. Normally we would do, normally in distributed, sorry, dedicated, we would use these for most tenants, but in US PubSec, we're going to use this. And I actually have a little cheat sheet, but so this would be path to the switchboard PubSec repo, and then under switchboard PubSec and tenant models, there's this tenant.json. Let's go back to my cheat sheet. Steal. Okay, so now we can, sure enough, it's in there, and validate is in fact the one we want. So Looks like we did the right thing there. Let's move back to this. And now this last one is going to start up the operator access pod inside of the AMP cluster. So let's go back to my cheat sheet real fast because I have a couple extra things in here. So we want to use the configure, I forget what dash S stands for, but I'm going to call it state. What that means is it's going to pull down a container image that is specifically set up for the configure step. And then time 14400 is the life of the container. By default, it's only an hour, which I have, while doing my various investigations, occasionally run over. This demo won't run over an hour, but I just like having a little extra time just in case I need it. So now what it's going to do is create that pod. And once the pod is created, it's going to remote shell into it. So the next prompt you see here, I'm now inside of the AMP cluster running a pod. We can actually verify, I'm not going to verify it, but just trust me, that's where we are. You can tell because the shell prompt changed. So the next step, if we go back to the documentation, there's a little bit more here. So this is spawning a pod inside the AMP cluster. The tenant model got passed into it. And you can use tenCuddle to perform tasks. The task we want to do first is to assume the provision AWS role. So we're going to do that. And we'll go back to my cheat sheet just to make sure I'm right. Yeah, there it is. So here's what we're doing. And it runs the script. And as soon as that's done, we'll be able to say, and you'll see AWS profile is set to provision. So that's good. Now let's jump back here. We can run this kubectl default git pods. Why not? I mean, it's just verifying that we can, in fact, do something now. Sure enough, there it is. But the kicker is this next thing. Note, if you're following instructions in the restore from backups runbook, return to those instructions now. Well, I didn't actually start there, but that is what we're doing. So we won't need the rest of this runbook. We can switch over to the restore from backups runbook now. So we'll do that. Now, what we're doing, if you go to the very top of the restore from backups runbook, there's a nice little table of contents here. And what we're dealing with is Gitaly. So we have a couple of options to recover volume into the original region or recover volume into a different region. We will be recovering into the original region because, as I stated earlier, there is no recovering into a different region in our FedRAMP offering at this moment. So let's get started. So we'll say these four commands are basically just setting some environment variables that will be used by later commands. So we can pretty much just accept them as is. It does echo out what it's setting at the end of each command, which is really valuable. So you can sort of spot check, sure enough, that is our account. Validate is the name of the tenant. USGovWest is where we are, and validate backups is going to be the name of the vault. So that all looks good. Let's then go, so confirm that we can see the vault. Enough, we got good output here. If you get a problem here, it can be worth making sure that you are in fact using the provision profile. If you're in the configure profile, then this won't work. So let's move on. identify which of the Gitaly EC2 instances you want to restore to. So let's go look at in EC2. We'll see there are several hosts running here. Let's sort by name. Nice. So we have three Gitaly hosts. And for the sake of argument, we will be recovering to Gitaly host number three. So there it is. We do, in fact, have a third one. So let's go over to the documentation again, which is here. And we'll say, identify which of the Gitaly EC2 is to restore to. So in this case, they have the example is two, but we're going to go for three. So let's go to three. Back to the documentation. And we'll just grab some. So again, we're just setting some variables that are going to be used by later commands. And you can see that some of the ones we set earlier, tenant region, is being used by this command. So they all kind of build on each other, instance ID. And this. Okay, good. So let's move on down. So here's a little snag. This block won't work in AWS GovCloud. So what this block does is it just lists all of the snapshot ARNs that are available. You can do that in the console as well. So let's go do that in the console. We will just go to backup and then vaults, then validate, which is the name of the tenant, backups. And you can see all of the snapshots that are living in here. So we are, it's just good. Let's get a couple more. It's easier to see. Okay, so you can see we've got, these are in time order, I believe. And I said we're restoring to Gitaly 3. So we want to Gitaly 3, oops, not going to that. We want a Gitaly 3 data. So we'll be looking for that. There's one, it's the most recent Gitaly 3 data. So we can hop in there and get the ARN. And that block that we looked at that I said wouldn't work, it would have listed all of those ARNs that we just looked at, but we've got it now. So we can just say RP ARN and then set it to what we just found. We go. All right. So that's the ARN that we're going to be restoring. And I just picked the most recent one, as you saw. If you need to go back farther, you can always find. You can always find an older one. So we've got lots of dates to choose from here. So if for some reason you need to go back in time, you can pick a different ARN. So back to the documentation for recovering, and we've done this, we've selected an ARN. So now we're just gonna grab some metadata. Let's go and fire this off. It doesn't echo this metadata out. I might add that, but if you're curious, you can pick this. It's just a little JSON blob. All right, so this is the actual kicker. And there is a note here. You can always watch for this in US AWS GovCloud. The note is that if we just take this blind and go and pop it in, we'll actually get an error. And that's because this string expects you to not be in GovCloud. The only difference, if we go back to the documentation, is that we replace AWS with AWS US Gov in the ARN, in the role ARN. So we'll just do that real fast. AWS, so it's right here, AWS-US-Gov. And then once you've added that, it'll work just fine. So that kicked it off. We are now restoring, and we've got a job ID here. So we can just keep our eye on it. using that command. And what it's going to do is every 10 seconds, it's going to echo out the state. Eventually, it will say completed. Okay, so it is now completed. And we can just break out of that loop. And let's go back to the documentation. If it fails, there's some other procedures you can do here. But we're going to just continue with the restore. So we need to set a couple environment variables. So let's do that. And again, we're just building on variables that we already have, restore volume arm, job ID, tenant region. So we've got the restored volume ID and the restored volume arm. We can go over here, I believe, and should be able to find that ID. Oops. Linux paste problems. Yeah, there it is. And we can see it's 150 gigs. So let's go back to the documentation. And we're going to tag it appropriately. And then we're going to attach it to the instance that we are working on. So attach volume. So the volume is now attached. And then if we want, we can check to make sure that it's attached this way. And sure enough. Okay. So it is now attached to that Gitaly volume. Again, if you want to, you can go look in here. I believe it will show. Yeah, so now it says that it's attached. Restored Gitaly 3 data. And back to the documentation. When this is complete, we can go to common procedure for restore data from recovered volume. So let's do that. So let me check my cheat sheet. I think we do need to switch to the configure role. Yeah, so we are going to switch to the configure role. So we'll actually take that string out of here though. And we'll just watch some output here for a second. And now you can see we are in the configure profile. So that's good. So now we want to remote into the instance that we've been working on, which in this case is the Gitaly 3 instance. So there we go. So again, we're just taking advantage of these environment variables that we've been building. And here we go, we're inside of Gitaly 3, great. LSBLK or list block will tell us all of the block devices that are mounted, and you'll be able to see there's gonna be one in here that in this case, it's NVMe 3 and 1, but you'll see there's one that isn't mounted. So these are the mount points along the right-hand side. There's this one, but if you follow it over, that's NVMe 1, and it has subpartitions that are mounted. So so that's how you can tell that's not the one we're dealing with. So in this case, NVMe 3 and 1 is the new disk, the 150 gig disk that we just made. So now we can say sudo EFCK. So what this is going to do is, and this, I'm going to copy this over and then I'm going to change 2 to 3. What this is going to do is check that recovered disk that we just created for errors. So just to make sure that we're not going to be recovering data from a damaged draft, and it's clean, so we're good to go. So now we can make a restore directory in slash mount. So just hit that, and there it is. Look, and right now it should be empty. Sure enough. And then we'll mount that drive that we've just created. So, and now if we go in, it's not empty anymore. Perfect. So now we have a copy of the data drive from when the snapshot was taken, and we have that mounted to this same server. So we could do any number of things here, from recovering just a single file that had been lost to recovering the entirety of the drive using whatever tools that you're used to. I'm not gonna go into that aspect of it because it has nothing to do with GovCloud. It will just work. But yeah, you can follow all of that here if you are so inclined. I'm gonna go ahead at this point. And so like I said, I'm skipping the actual like inside of Linux restoration, but it's there, you can do it. And the next step I'm gonna take is actually cleaning up. So at this point, we've done some restoration and we're gonna clean up. So let's come back out of that drive. We can actually do ls blk, and you'll see now it is that same drive NVMe is mounted to mount restore, and we're gonna unmount it. And so that's done. And we can just exit out at this point. Okay, so now we're back in our pod that's running inside the AMP cluster. And from here, we can do some cleanup. Oh yeah, rsync is how the instructions have that set up. Okay, so I've just unmounted. They're gonna want us to be in the provision. Profile. So again, we'll do, let's see, we're in provision now. So let's detach the volume. So we're detaching this volume we created from the Gitaly 3 instance. That's done. And then we'll delete the volume. We do want to clean up because otherwise we end up with lots of extra volume sitting around, which we end up having to pay for. So let's just go back to here, and this volume should actually be, yeah, it does not exist. So it's been removed. We're all cleaned up. We've presumably restored whatever we needed, and we can carry on. So that's how you do that in GovCloud. Of course, probably the last step here would be to exit out of the pod. And now I'm just back on my regular workstation. And if you want, you can say git pods or kubectl git pods. I have an alias set up. And it should just show up as completed operator access. Well, I guess it's still running, but it will tear itself down after 1440. I had one that I started earlier today. Or if you want, you can tear it down yourself. So you can say, hey, delete pod. Trust me, this is going to work. I'm just going to let this finish, but this concludes this particular demo. Thanks.